We have our College of Nursing disaster simulations. These are level 3 pre-licensure nurses, and they're coming here to do a disaster preparedness simulation. We're having some skill stations in the morning. They have stop the bleed, salt triage, safety patient transfers, and they're going to apply all of those skills in the actual scenario in the afternoon.
This is a great opportunity for them to learn some of the critical skills that they might not get to see in certain areas of the hospital if they don't work in the emergency department.
A lot of the techniques we're going to teach you today for stopping severe bleeding are what's going to get someone to the hospital in hopefully a really good condition.
We have experts, we have, you know, all the skills, the mannequins, the moulage, we have the task trainers, so it actually, I think it makes it exciting for them to be part of such an amazing field.
You know, nursing school gives them a lot of things that are important. If I can bring some of the things that I learned in the field to help them better care for patients, that's going to be the best outcome for everyone.
Wave your hand!
Wave!
We try to present the information that conveys the seriousness of the training while still keeping it engaging so, you know, individuals can learn these techniques in a fairly relaxed environment.
We really want to make sure we're presenting it in a way that minimizes stress.
You're going to be okay. You promise?
So that's why you're going to hear a lot of laughing. It's a very, very fun training, but it's still getting that information across that they can use any time of day.
Okay, can someone help me lift her?
Yeah.
When a bunch of patients are brought into the hospital, it kind of becomes a field incident. People flood into the emergency room on foot traffic or through ambulances, and there's just patients everywhere.
Are you doing okay, ma'am?
Getting them at the beginning of their career was filling this large gap that we had of individuals that have been in the field for quite some time and have that historical knowledge, rather than people trying to race to catch up to find out what they need to do and how they can help.
The younger you can learn anything, the easier it's going to sink in, the more time you're going to have to develop those skills before you get into a hospital setting.
I need a backboard.
We want to make sure that they're trained to help in any time of day, any situation, even if they're not in that clinical setting.
If they are strongly trained in these things and know the proper steps to take, that's going to save the most amount of patients.